state's attorney and their inability to have that tool to leverage a plea. But I'm here, Senator Stone, with three sets of numbers. 13% of the American population is African American. 37% of our inmate population is African American. And 41% of those who are on death row in this country are African American. It just doesn't add up. It just doesn't add up. I have concerns and fears that my little black son, Jonathan, may unfortunately and out of his control get caught up in a situation when he's 18 years old and maybe he'll get arrested. And when we live in a society where we have a system that is more likely to put him on death row than a similarly situated kid who's white, I got a problem with that. We should have a problem with that. And as much as we seek to improve this system of justice each and every day, and there are men and women who, including you, that do that, there are biases in the system that we'll never eliminate in our lifetime. You're going to hear, I believe, from a former death row inmate in Maryland who's white, Mr. Bloodworth. He spent 2 years on death row. He was exonerated from DNA evidence, but it was only fortuitous that they found the evidence that was used to exonerate him with DNA fingerprinting. There are too many mistakes in this system. 140 Americans since 1977 have been exonerated from death row. 41% African American in a population where we represent 13%. There are biases in the system.